40 minutes of nonstop rock with WMJR.
It's Halloween every day.
That must have been a pretty gory spectacle.
Because our music marathons are pretty monstrous.
A ghastly creature created from an atomic mutation.
In fact, it's pretty darn scary how much rock we play. Classic rock.
This is going to be some party, I'll tell you that.
At last, it is here.
WMJI 102.7, the Rock of Freesnopolis, in the midst of our Rocktober celebrations, and in the middle of our, towards the end, actually, of our weekends with Ryan Young on a Sunday night. Going to do our Rocktober Rock Blocks this hour. That's three songs in a row from the same artist, put together in a nice little rock and roll package for you. And tonight, as promised, we're going to do ZZ Top and Stone Temple Pilots, but first, going to start off with some Van Halen, strictly DLR Van Halen tonight. Three songs from the David era, and I think they are definitely a welcome addition to the show tonight, where you're missing Eddie Van Halen very much. Rocktober Rock Blocks.
Show you love, man.
won't let you pass.
Thank you.
WMJI 102.7, the Rock of Freesenopolis. I am still Ryan Young, and this is still Weekends with Ryan Young for another hour and a half here or so. That was a Rocktober rock block from the Mighty VH. Van Halen checking in with I'm the One, The Full Bug, and Dance the Night Away. And we are going to continue to do just that, dancing this night away to great music. Still to come, a rock block from ZZ Top. And right now we're going to do a rock block from Stone Temple Pilots. WMJI 102.7, The Rock of Freesenopolis.
Lady picture, she hides behind the bed.
Weekends with Ryan Young on WMJI 102.7, The Rock of Freesenopolis. I am Ryan Young, and that was a Rocktober rock block from the one, the only STP, Stone Temple Pilots. Wicked Garden from their first album, Core, starting it off. Lady Picture Show from Tiny Gifts from the Vatican Gift Shop. And Hollywood Bitch, which is from the album Shangri-La. And Hollywood Bitch is actually about an actual Hollywood bitch. It's about Courtney Love. It is, you know, it's funny because almost every lead singer or band member of a prominent alternative 90s grunge rock band has some sort of song or story or attitude about Courtney Love. She just didn't make a lot of friends, made a lot of enemies. We all know Dave Grohl is a huge fan of her nonsense, and I guess also the lead singer, Scott Weiland, rest in peace, from Stone Temple Pilots, had a major issue with her as well, and that song is about Courtney Love, the Hollywood bitch. Just so you know, in case you hadn't already figured that out, I guess it's kind of obvious to anyone who knows the story of Courtney Love and the fact that she is a Hollywood bitch. So, okay, that is it for the... No, we're going to do a quick break. That's right. I'm getting ahead of myself. I'm already halfway into the next hour. We're going to do a quick break, and then when we're back, we'll get our last rock block for the hour, which is a beautiful block of ZZ Top in our Rocktober rock block on WMJI 102.7.
We're dealing with sick people here.
Fuck you, 1000%!
If you didn't know, I was wearing my special super thermal B long underwear.
Another pretty boy wanker masquerading.
Fuck you, your asshole! It's perfect donkey asshole!
You want to be a disc jockey?
Very much so. I've wanted to be a disc jockey since I was 7 years old.
What are you, an idiot?
No, sir, I'm not an idiot. In fact, I have a communications degree from Boston University, and I would work very hard for this company if given the opportunity
to see me.
How do you justify such behavior?
What's on the menu, pal? I'm starved.